Today, I want to show you how to use Adobe Firefly's new text to video feature and image video to feature. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. I'm excited to show you how to use Adobe Firefly to create these videos just from a prompt. So I'll walk through all the different ways you can do that in Adobe Firefly. But I also want to focus on the prompt structure to get a good video out of it. So we'll go through that step by step as well. Now, the other thing I want to point out, I'm using a standard Adobe account here. You can use a free account to get some prompts done, but it does run out pretty quickly after maybe about two or three different video generations, but it does give you a chance to play with it. But all that said, let's get started with how to create these videos from a simple text prompt in Adobe Firefly. I'm logged into my Adobe Firefly account, and what I want to focus on today is right under here, and that's video. These two things, text to video, where I just put in a prompt and it creates a 5-second video, and I can also start from an image and then put my prompt in to turn that into a video. But I do want to point out, inside Adobe Firefly, you can do many different things. If you want to create your images, text to image, you have generative fill. This is something I want to play around a little bit more with, creating 3D shapes, but you can see all the different things that they have in here. And even with audio, we have translate audio, enhanced speech, text avatar, and vector. So you can create your own text vectors here with a simple prompt. But let's go over to video here. I want to point out up top, I could do a prompt up here to start with video or drop down with image. But we're going to start with text to video here, and I'm going to go ahead and put a prompt in here and then show you how we can adjust it. Now let's go ahead and add a simple prompt to this. I'm just going to start with this. Eagle soaring over snow-capped mountains. And I could add a little bit more to make more detailed, and I'll do that in a moment. Now, I want to point out over on the general settings over here, notice it shows the model that we're in. If we wanted it widescreen, that's what it's on right now, I can switch to portrait. As I open up any of these, I can choose different cameras. So from the shot size, if I drop down, I'm going to say I want a medium shot on this one. What's the camera angle? Let's go with the eye level shot. And what do I want for a motion? So maybe I want it to move right. And we'll see if all these things work or not. I know when I've been playing around with it, sometimes it works well, other times it doesn't. And I do find as I add more detail to the prompt, it seems to help. So right now, let's go ahead and generate. Generally, it takes about 60 seconds or so to get this done. These are going to be 5-second clips, and they're going to be at 1080p. All right, here we go. It's all done. You can see it's 5 seconds, and I can see right away we have a medium shot. It's at eye level, and let's play it to see if it moves to the right. Well, it's doing some weird things there, multiple eagles flying. So you can see how it's adapted there already. But let's try to adapt our prompt and see if we can get this doing something a little bit better. If you like the video that you create, the download is right up top here. But let's go ahead and tweak this now. And I'm going to use more of a structured approach to a text to video. So something to think about when you're creating a prompt, you know, think about having the structure of a detailing shot type, a character, an action, a location, and aesthetic. This is going to help Firefly or other text video editors create a better end product for you. So you can see how I have the different camera angles in here. I have the character, the setting, and the aesthetics all in this. I'm going to go back over here and just switch this to none because I've placed it into my prompt and we'll see what we get. All right, let's test this out. I'm just going to expand this to full screen and I'm going to hit play. So we definitely get a lot more detail to everything on there. I'm going to go back one more time and just hit play from here. So I have a cinematic close-up shot of a majestic eagle soaring over snow-capped mountains at dawn. And it looks like it's getting that all inside of that with intricate feather details and a golden sunlight illuminating scene. And I won't say it's perfect, but that description, when I wrote all those different things in there, it seems like it's all been added. Like even when you think about the details of the feather, it looks like dawn. We have the snow-capped mountains. So let's try another one now. Okay, this time I want to do one with even more detail, and we'll see what we get here. So I'll just move up, and this is the one that I want to create. And remember the criteria that I told you before? I'll put that down below in the description so you can just check off that if you're writing yourself to make sure you have all those different criteria. So I have a dramatic low angle shot of a vintage steam engine train chugging through a foggy countryside at twilight. The train's billowing smoke contrast with the cool, muted tones of the landscape, evoking a sense of mystery. I kind of feel like I went overboard on this one. I haven't tried this prompt, but we'll go ahead and generate and see what we get. Here we go. It still only took about a minute or less to create these. I want to point out too, I did leave the move right. I forgot I even had this on. So I would imagine this is going to be moving from the right here to the right. So if I hit play, dramatic low angle, I would say this is on the lower side of a shot. Vintage steam engine, yes, chugging. I notice I'm going to go back one more time, hit play. The wheels are a little wonky on how they're moving and everything. But it's kind of neat. Like this is, I think about this as being the beginning part of this text to video and where this will be in 2 months from now, 4 months, 6 months, and how when these clips get longer and when you can put them all together to create your own videos, I think it will be pretty amazing. I want to do one more example here, and then I'm going to show you how you can start your video from an image that you have. And the example I want to try, and I haven't tried this one yet, is a stop motion style video of a tiny robot exploring a vibrant overgrown garden. The scene features playful colors, gentle camera tilt. I have no idea what's going to happen here, so let's give this a try. All right, here we go. We have our 5 second click, or all right, here we go. We have our 5 second clip. Let's give it a try. The feet are kind of moving a little bit, I can see down there, but it is very stop motion. I would say yes, lots of playful colors, gentle camera angle tilt. I don't know if I saw much of that in there, maybe slightly, but you can see with the prompt, and again, I totally forgot about this move, right? I could have changed this into a different one, but I've kept that on throughout these videos. I'll have to remember to change it for the next one. But I just wanted to show you different styles that you can bring into this. And again, thinking about your prompt, what you want to achieve with your video. With image to video, I can do it right here with the first frame. I'm going to go back up here and I want to point out, so if I go to video, you'll notice image to video right here. If I click on it, it brings me to the same thing. So this is where I'm going to place it. But before I do that, what I want to do is I'm going to go and create an image using Firefly here. So if I was just going to use text to image, I can give it a prompt like I've been giving before. And so this time I want a detailed oil painting portrait of a medieval knight, shining armor, standing in front of a grand castle at sunset. I want to see if I can take this painting that it creates here, bring it back over and turn it into a 5 second video with another prompt after that. So let's go to we'll go widescreen like before, 16:9, and content type. Well, let's make this art and see what we can get. Composition, I'm going to leave this all the same right here, and I'm going to go ahead and generate. All right, I have some images here. So what I'm going to do is actually this one right here. I'm going to use this one and I'm just going to go and download it here. And then I'm going to use it as a upload inside my image to video over here. So let's go and use upload now. And I just did that to my downloads. Here it is right here. I'm going to agree. And let's go give it a prompt now. Now, I think I'm going overboard on this a bit, on this prompt. And again, I haven't tested these out, so I want to be kind of surprised with you if this works. So in this case, I have my picture where it's going to start. The knight steps out from the frame and begins walking along a stone courtyard. The camera slowly zooms and pans across the scene, revealing a bustling medieval activity. So you can see how I have peasants and banners and different, and I have talked about the lighting and the golden hues of sunset, all this. I think I'm going over the top here, but I'm really curious what it can do here. So let's go ahead and generate. Okay, let's see what we have now. I'm going to go ahead, hit play. Oh, it was starting to move. I saw the hair move a little bit. Okay, so yes, it is stepping out of frame. It's going, we can see from the back now, has the helmet on. It's kind of changed. I kind of thought something like this might happen. I knew I was kind of pushing on, I was taking some leaps on what maybe what I was thinking of it, and I knew I wouldn't be able to fill in. But it goes to show you what will be possible. And as you get these prompts and learn to kind of prompt it the way you want, and I think what's going to happen as we get all these different settings here, you'll be able to just go through and pick these. I do find it with a lot of these different prompts, it's good to use a different AI, whether it be ChatGPT or Gemini, to help you write these once you put a few ideas in, and then you can bring them back over here to test them out. Now, I went and changed my prompt here, and I'm going to add an end frame. So what the end frame does is you can write your prompt and it's going to be the picture where it ends. But what I'm going to try doing here is, so I have this beginning prompt here, beginning image, and I have an end image. So I want her to turn around and first smile at the camera, then turn around and look at the castle. And that's the last picture over here, is just her back to it. So let's see what happens. Okay, let's test this one out. And I already know that there'll be a problem because the castle in my second picture is different than the castle in my first one. So let's go ahead and play this. Does she smile? Kind of. Boy, she has some weird things happening to her face. I can see how the castle changes. I just kind of want to show the point of this, though that was probably not the best example between two pictures, but it did merge from one to the other. So remember about your prompt, how you're writing it to get the most out of it. The other thing, I'm going to go back here, and you'll notice that under files, it's going to show from everything from the images that I created, all the different videos here. And you'll notice that you have different options where you can delete or open them. So what do you think of all of this? You know, test out the free option. You'll have a free, maybe one or two that you can create. It doesn't take too long till you're out of them. But it gives you an understanding of where text to video is going. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.